Good morning. My name is Robert McCaw. I am the National Government Affairs Director with the Council on American Islamic Relations, the nation's largest Muslim civil rights and advocacy organization. Today we are joined by other Muslim, Arab American, Asian American, anti-torture and anti-war organizations at the National Press Club to urge the Senate Foreign Relations Committee to vote no on the nomination of Mike Pompeo to Secretary of State. We'll be hearing from speakers from each of our organizations. And the first speaker I'm going to introduce is Nihad Awad. He is the National Executive Director of CARE.
Thank you, Robert. Good morning. Nihad Awad, the Council on American Islamic Relations. I want to thank this diverse group of organizations that I'm surrounded by today: American Muslim, Asian American, Arab American, anti-torture, and anti-war. We are here for a single purpose. We are here to urge the Senate Foreign Relations Committee to vote no on the confirmation of Mike Pompeo as Secretary of State because of his history of Islamophobia, discrimination, ties to anti-Muslim hate groups, support for torture and war footing. Mike Pompeo has framed the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan as religious wars. Mike Pompeo would move the United States closer to war with Iran. In November 2016, Mike Pompeo tweeted that he looks forward to rolling back the nuclear Iran deal. I am personally afraid that Trump is creating a war cabinet, joining the likes of John Bolton and potentially Gina Haspel as CIA director. Mike Pompeo has defended the CIA's notorious use of torture under the George W. Bush administration. As a congressman, Mike Pompeo stated, quote, the program being used were within the law, within the Constitution, unquote. Our nation could find itself in a disastrous war with Iran or North Korea. People like Pompeo, who have Islamophobic views, should never work closely with our government, let alone to be in the highest level of policy making. This appointment has the potential to harm our nation's image and our relations with key players in the international community. CARE has looked at his record. We published his record. We only found anti-Muslim bigotry and many dangerous and divisive policies that would impede his ability to successfully carry out the duties of Secretary of State. We found Pompeo openly supports anti-Muslim hate groups. In 2016, then Congressman Mike Pompeo spoke at a legislative briefing for the anti-Muslim hate group Act for America. Pompeo has received the Act for America National Security Eagle Award for 2016. Act for America's founder, Brigitte Gabriel, outrageously claimed that, quote, a practicing Muslim who believes in the teachings of the Quran cannot be a loyal citizen to the United States of America, unquote. The hate group's website at the time also noted that, unquote, the next CIA representative, Mike Pompeo, has been a steadfast ally of ours since the day he was elected to Congress, unquote. Pompeo has been interviewed on anti-Muslim hate group Center for Security Policy leader Frank Gaffney's online radio show more than 20 times. Pompeo has also toxic, antagonistic relationship with the American Muslim community. In 2013, following the Boston Marathon tragedy, Pompeo falsely claimed that American Muslims and their leaders are potentially complicit in crimes for failing to speak out, even though the American Muslim community and its leaders had already condemned that attack on the communities in Boston. And we have consistently and regularly condemned acts of violence. It is critical to have the right person lead the State Department. To be the head of American diplomacy around the world requires a different person than Mike Pompeo, someone who believes in peace. How will Pompeo deal with genocide in our lifetime? How will he impartially deal with the ethnic cleansing of Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar when he promotes Islamophobia in America? Pompeo openly associates with anti-Muslim hate groups. I have zero confidence in his ability to promote the values of America and universal values of fairness, human rights, respect, and dignity. Part of the job of the Secretary of State is working with Muslim-majority countries. Confirming Pompeo to this position will send a very wrong message to the Muslim world and our allies in the Muslim world. We at CARE like to thank those senators on the Foreign Relations Committee who called Pompeo out during last week's confirmation hearing. I personally would like to thank Senator Cory Booker from New Jersey for exposing Pompeo's close ties to the notorious anti-Muslim hate groups Act for America and Center for Security Policy. I would like to thank Senator Edward Markey for standing with American Muslim families and leaders in Boston for grilling Pompeo on his previous false accusations that Muslims are collectively responsible for violent and criminal acts. I also would like to thank Senator Jean Shaheen from New Hampshire, Senator Christopher Coons, and Senator Bob Menendez for standing up to the Muslim for the Muslim community and opposing Pompeo's anti-Muslim bigotry. It is important also to recognize Senators Tim Kaine from Virginia, Ben Cardin from Maryland, Rand Paul, and every other senator who has pledged that they will vote no for Pompeo. We call on all Republicans to join their colleagues to vote against Pompeo, and also to urge other senators to vote against him, whether in the committee or on the floor. During his confirmation hearing, Pompeo kept saying his record speaks for itself when answering questions about his Islamophobic ties to anti-Muslim hate groups. Well, it does speak for itself. He is an Islamophobe. I will close by calling on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee to vote no on the confirmation of Mike Pompeo as Secretary of State because of his history of Islamophobia, discrimination, ties to anti-Muslim hate groups, support for torture, and war footing. Our nation cannot afford this risk. Thank you.
Thank you, Nihad. Our next speaker is Enji Mohsen, and she is with the Muslim Public Affairs Council. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Enji Mohsen. I am the Policy Program Manager at the Muslim Public Affairs Council. We work to improve public understanding and policies that impact American Muslims by engaging government, media, and communities. MPAC strongly opposes the nomination of Mike Pompeo as Secretary of State. Pompeo has a long and well-documented history of discriminatory statements towards Muslims. Pompeo is strongly associated with Act for America and the Center for Security Policy, the most influential anti-Muslim hate groups as designated by the Southern Poverty Law Center. As chief diplomat, the Secretary of State will work negotiations, diffuse crises, and tackle issues that require a credible and fair-minded person toward foreign nations, of which approximately 50 have a Muslim majority. Pompeo has previously voiced support for policy within the State Department that would peddle mistrust and fear of American Muslims and chill American Muslim civic and political participation. Therefore, MPAC strongly urges the Senate Committee on Foreign Relations to consider these facts and the impact on the American Muslim community when voting on Mike Pompeo's nomination for Secretary of State. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Angie. Our next speaker is Reverend Ron Stafe. He is the Executive Director of the National Religious Campaign Against Torture and Action Fund.
I'm Reverend Ron Stafe. I'm the Executive Director of the National Religious Campaign Against Torture Action Fund. And we are a coalition of 330 faith organizations across the United States, across the ideological spectrum. We are rabbis and nuns and imams and priests and ministers and congregational leaders from across the country. When I was at the hearings when Mike Pompeo was being looked at by the Senate Intelligence Committee for his post that he now holds at the CIA, and although he stated that he was aware that CIA torture is now illegal thanks to Senate action in 2015, he never once repudiated what he had said earlier about his support for torture earlier in his career. He didn't walk back on that as an individual. That was highly problematic for our coalition, and we opposed his position then. We now oppose his nomination to serve as Secretary of State. And I want to say something about my friends and allies that are here, because support for torture and Islamophobia and targeting Muslims grew up as twin evils during the same post 9/11 environment, and now we're seeing some of the ripple effects. Mike Pompeo is one of the leaders of the pro-torture, anti-Muslim movement in this country, and there's no way that we can put somebody like that in the president's cabinet. There's no way that somebody like that is qualified to serve anywhere in the State Department, and for sure not to head our State Department. So our coalition is proud to stand with our friends here and oppose Mike Pompeo and urge that the Senate Foreign Relations Committee and the full Senate vote him down and keep him out of the State Department. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ron. Our next speaker is Megan Aseb. She's the Director of Immigration Advocacy for Asian Americans Advancing Justice.
Hi, I'm Megan Esaham. I'm the Director of Immigration Advocacy at Asian Americans Advancing Justice, AAJC. We're here to stand with CARE and our other colleagues and echo their sentiments. We oppose the nomination of Mike Pompeo due to his bigotry and Islamophobia. Our nation needs a Secretary of State who can build bridges and unity around the world, not someone to spread hate. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Megan. Our next speaker is Osama Abushaid. He is the National Policy Director for American Muslims for Palestine, AMP.
Good morning. The American Muslims for Palestine, a national education and a grassroots-based organization dedicated to educating the American public about Palestine and its rich cultural, historical, and religious heritage, joins other civil human rights and faith leaders in urging Senate Foreign Relations Committee members not to approve Mike Pompeo's nomination as Secretary of State. In addition to other reasons that were mentioned a while ago for opposing his nomination, it is important to note here that the influence of the so-called adult wing within the Trump administration has been steadily diminishing now. Two leading figures of this wing were either fired, like the former Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, or forced to resign, like the former National Security Advisor H.R. McMaster. The latter was replaced by the ideologue John Bolton, and the same thing could happen in the State Department if Pompeo is confirmed. The Trump administration needs now more than ever more adults and less ideologue. It's taking on critical issues now, like the upcoming negotiations with North Korea, the Middle East crisis, and other issues, among them strained relations with allies. There are so many issues that this administration is dealing with, and it's presiding over a total chaos. Many parts of the world is in chaos, and we cannot inject more chaos into the Trump administration with all the ramifications that this could bring to the US and to the world. This requires putting policy over politics and common sense over ideology. Given his past, Mike Pompeo is not the right choice for Secretary of State. He never demonstrated the qualities to hold this highest position in the US US cabinet, and there is no reason to believe that he will be different should he be confirmed. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Osama. Our next speaker is Abed Ayoub. He's the Director of Legal and Policy Affairs for the Arab American Anti-Discrimination Committee, also known as ADC. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Abed Ayoub, Legal and Policy Director of ADC. We're the country's largest Arab American civil rights organization, and we unequivocally stand against Mike Pompeo's nomination for Secretary of State, and we urge the Senate Foreign Relations Committee also to vote him down. Throughout his career, Pompeo has shown an affinity and a love for Islamophobia and everything racist, and his inability to distance himself from individuals in his past, like Frank Gaffney and Bridget Gabriel, and his positions on torture, further prove that he's unfit to serve as America's top diplomat. And during these challenging times around the world, this country cannot afford to have and cannot take the risk to have somebody like Mike Pompeo leading diplomatic efforts on behalf of the United States. So we urge the Senate Foreign Relations Committee to do what's right, reject this nomination, vote him down, and move forward into nominating, the administration should move forward to nominating an adult into the position and somebody with more character and somebody that could better represent the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Abed. And our next and final speaker is Erica Fine, and she is with Win Without War.
Hi, I'm Erica Fine. I'm the Advocacy Director at Win Without War, which is a national coalition of organizations working to make foreign policy more progressive. I want to thank CARE for inviting us today and for holding this important conference. Mike Pompeo's confirmation to CIA Director and now nomination for Secretary of State has been about normalizing hate in the White House. During his confirmation hearing, he refused to apologize for his statement accusing all Muslims of being complicit in the Boston Marathon attacks. For years, he has participated in conservative dog whistling, especially against Muslims, and has a special fervor for peddling conspiracy theories against his political opponents. This alone should be enough to disqualify him for Senate confirmation or for any of our nation's top jobs. But unfortunately, his disqualifications run much deeper. When it comes to foreign policy, his politics don't stop at the water's edge. While Pompeo was a congressman from Kansas, he loved to team up with hawks in Congress to deny the President Obama's initiatives, and especially the Iran nuclear deal. He has not ruled out preventive war with both Iran and North Korea. He denies climate change is real. He has a long record of opposing rights for LGBT people and has called CIA officials that participated in the torture program patriots. It is for all of these reasons that Win Without War has strongly led the charge to oppose his nomination and will hold all senators accountable that ultimately support him. Overall, more than 180 organizations representing tens of millions of Americans have come out to block Pompeo's ascension to one of the highest positions in our government. Hundreds of thousands of people have taken action by calling and emailing their senators. On Monday, Pompeo could be the first nominee ever to be reported unfavorably by the Senate Foreign Relations Committee if a majority of the committee votes not to confirm him. And yet, Leader McConnell will push his nomination to the floor for a vote. The math is not in our favor to block Pompeo since Democratic Senator Heidi Heitkamp declared she will support him. But we must and we will continue to fight until the very end. People have asked, how will we do better than Rex Tillerson? How could we do worse than Rex Tillerson? Tillerson is no hero, but his fatal flaw in the eyes of his boss was that he was too independent, too willing to support negotiations and diplomacy. Trump has now tapped a yes man, someone willing to hedge on whether Russia systematically attacked our nation during the 2016 election so as not to upset his boss. We cannot trust this man to fight against Trump's worst instincts and stand up against a march to war. So far, over half of the Democratic caucus agrees and have publicly opposed Pompeo's nomination. One Republican, Senator Rand Paul, has vowed to fight against his nomination and the forming of a war cabinet. So to use the words of Secretary-designate Pompeo, all patriots, all senators who consider themselves patriots should vote against Mike Pompeo and show that they will not tolerate the spreading of extremism and the path to war within our government. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Erica. I think what we can hear from all these speakers is one clear message, that the Senate Foreign Relations Committee needs to vote no on this nomination for Mike Pompeo to Secretary of State. And for those who are watching this video, we have a call to action. If you're watching this video before Monday's votes, you need to call your senator, you need to call members of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, and you have to tell them to stay firm and to vote no against this nomination. If this nomination fails in the Foreign Relations Committee, it could still procedurally be moved to the Senate floor for a vote, something that is shameful but could happen. If that's the case, then we have till Thursday next week to convince our senators to vote no. We need more Republicans to join their colleague, Senator Rand Paul, in voting no on this confirmation. We need all Democrats to stand firm and to vote no on this nomination. So please call your senator. Please tell them to vote no on this nomination. Stand against bigotry. Stand for justice. Make sure that we have the right people that are nominated for these policy-making decisions. And thank you.